Now you're about to meet someone who takes the concept of a one-man band about as far as you can go. See for yourself.
Ken Butler has built over 300 different instruments, but you won't find any of them in your neighborhood music store. Ken takes things other people think of as junk and transforms them into sculpture. The result is music to his ears. When Ken was growing up, he always saw himself as an artist more than a musician. Then, almost 20 years ago, he saw a way to merge the two talents. He started by creating musical instruments out of an odd assortment of objects. One of his first designs was this one-of-a-kind briefcase.
When I actually put the strings on it and strung it up and put the microphones on it, a certain sound would result. And if the sound was great, then I would use it as an instrument that I would perhaps perform on. If it didn't sound great, then it's just a piece of sculpture.
Ken finds the parts he needs everywhere from garbage cans to garage sales. He also haunts music stores, searching for damaged instruments or cheap parts.
Yeah, as always, I'm just looking to see if you got any broken junk or anything like that here.
What, like bodies or necks? Well, or
mostly necks. I'm always looking for necks. You got any?
Yeah, actually, there's one right there. Oh, yeah. Check that out. That's great. That's awesome. I wish there were more people doing stuff like this around. I mean, it's cool, you know, creating form and function together.
He's made a sitar from a record player, a violin from a tennis racket, and a guitar made from a shovel. He can get a tone from just about anything and turn himself into a one-man symphony. Ken pays his bills by performing and by selling sculptures like this. He calls it an urban piano. It's part keyboard, part radio. Believe it or not, Ken's also built a double-axe cello the hockey golf, the brush axe. But those are simple compared to pieces like this.
Well, this is one of my favorite ones. So there's an aluminum cane and an aluminum tennis racket, and then there's part of a vegetable slicer and part of the inside of a little toy gun, part of a comb, two strings here. This could be plucked or bowed.
Ken often closes his shows by playing the simplest instrument of all, his head.
So if you clamp on the microphone then and bite on it a little bit, you will be able to hear the resonance in your actual skull. So here's how that might work.
While Ken's instruments may be off the wall, his approach to music is not.
So when I play, I try to just make it as musical and as spiritual and as emotional and as dramatic and, you know, as serious as possible, because I'm playing a toothbrush or an umbrella, but I'm trying to really play it. I'm not making spoofing a Led Zeppelin tune or something. I'm really trying to play from, deep in my heart and soul.